When I was dirt poor, I thought that if I made millions and millions, that if I have money, I have no problems and I'll be happy. And the reality is that I was empty inside. Asian financial crisis, my family got completely wiped out. My mom, through her love, convinced me that I should go and make something of myself despite the financial situation that we're in. So the first thing I did before entering Harvard is I created a spreadsheet of daily expenses. Any excess money I received from my teaching in Muay Thai or my other odd jobs that I had, went to my mother. My second year, in the second semester, she eventually decided to come live with me and in my dorm. Whenever I thought things were at a low point, there are tougher days, and I managed to live on $4 a day. I was very lucky that there was a Korean buffet place nearby school, and for a little bit over $3, I could have all I could eat, and so I was relished that moment, you know? Asia's been the home of martial arts for 5,000 years. There's a martial art in every single country that's homegrown, part of society, part of culture, part of tradition, part of history. And yet, I also saw that every region of the world had several multi-billion dollar sports media properties. In North America, you had NFL, NBA, NASCAR, UFC, Major League Baseball, and they're all worth anywhere from $4 billion to $30 billion apiece. You go to Europe, it's the same thing. English Premier League, Formula One, Bundesliga, Spanish Liga, all worth $2 billion to $30 billion apiece. You come to Asia at that time, there's nothing, literally nothing on a pan-Asian basis. There was IPL, a cricket league in India worth $1 billion, and a couple soccer leagues here and there, but nothing of significance. So I thought to myself, but what is more Asian than martial arts? And no one had ever tried to unite 4 billion people, the world's largest population base, around one sports property. And I said, man, there's gotta be a way. If Conor McGregor was a free agent, one championship would not try to sign him. We don't want somebody to swear at people, throw water bottles, disrespect people, call out people's wives and children, and other, in my opinion, distasteful stuff that are not representative of true martial arts. We have heroes like Angela Lee, who is one of the best pound-for-pound female world champions on the planet, but yet she is humble, she's kind, she's sweet. You have Edward Folayang, who came from extreme poverty, conquered so many impossible odds. He's so humble and gentle and kind. These are the heroes that I want to support. It's because we understand the DNA of the Asian audience. We connect deeply. We connect deeply culturally, historically, traditionally, by showcasing the beauty of true martial arts as opposed to glorifying a fight. So I think, UFC is a fight. UFC is a sport. One championship is martial arts.